I'm Ben, and this is Hyperfine, resources and tutorials for architects by architects. Today I'm talking about solar shading for passive solar design. Passive solar design is one of the most common sustainable design strategies. We want to block the summer sun, but we want to allow the winter sun to pass through into our buildings. There are many tutorials out there on how to do shading studies in Revit. Today I'm going to talk about how you figure out exactly how deep this overhang has to be. Instead of trial and error and spending a lot of time guessing and redoing your studies, I'm going to share my method for setting this shading structure to the exact size you need it so you get it right on the first try. I'll also share a few methods you can choose to model these different shading elements. I'm not doing a full tutorial on that in this video, but I will make this file available as a free download on hyperfinearchitecture.com. Check out the free resources page and the professional courses page. Let's get started. All right, the first step is figuring out what the solar altitude is. That is the height of the sun, right? And we care about 2 days in particular. June 21st, the summer solstice, that's the highest point. And then December 21st, the winter solstice, when we want to allow all that sun to come through. The sun will be lower. There's lots of charts and tables out there. I like to use this website, sunpositioninfo.com. And basically, you fill in your location. They can do anywhere in the world. I'm here in the District of Columbia. And basically, you check sun position calculator and you get this table. And what it tells you is the time of the day, the azimuth, which is the angle that you're seeing the sun, and then the altitude, which is the height. And basically, we want to scroll down until we find the highest point, and that's 75 degrees. So that means the sun is going to be in the summer 75 degrees above the horizon. That happens at 13:15, which is 1:15 in the afternoon. So I'm going to write down that 75 degrees, and then I'm going to set to December and update. And we'll do the same thing. We'll see at the highest point in the winter, the sun is at about 28 degrees above the horizon, and that happens around noon. So I'll write that one down as well, 28. So with those two numbers, we're going to go back into Revit. Okay, so we're in Revit. I'm in a section of this wall system that we're working on. And basically what I want to do is I want to find where 75 degrees is from the horizon and measure that from the bottom of my window. So I'm going to draw a line that just basically represents the horizon. And if I draw another one up in this direction, then I'll set a dimension. I'll set an angular dimension from that red line down to this horizon. I'll select that red line and I'll set the angle to 75. So that was the 75 degrees that we found for the table basically. That is where the sun is going to be coming from. And we want to set it, we want to figure that out off the bottom of the window because we want the glazing to be completely shaded. So you can see the line starts about the window and it heads up. All we have to do to figure out our overhang is draw a line from the wall out to that sun line, that line that represents the sun. And we see it's 1:7 in some fraction. So if I just make it 1:9, I think that's going to work. I can come into plan. I'm just going to build a floor real quick. I'm going to set the length to 1 foot 9 inches. I'm going to set it up to, I figured this out earlier, but basically I'm going to set the height of the floor so it's up at the top of that window. And there we go. So now you see what happens is if I get an overhang at that distance, that ray of sun coming down is not going to be able to get to the window. It's going to have to stop right there. So all the rays are going to stop right there outside the overhang. That's going to come down, and at that same angle, it's going to miss the window. I changed angle a little bit there by accident, but you can see the purpose of that. All right, so we're going to do the same thing again for the winter, just to make sure that our overhang isn't too deep. So I'll draw a line, I'll set an angular dimension, and in the winter, the sun is coming from 28 degrees. There we go. So now if I just copy this up to right there, I'll see that the overhang is actually blocking just a little bit of the sun. All right, I paused the video, I improved this graphic a little bit, but you can see basically what's happening is in the summer, the sun is coming from this really steep angle it comes down, the overhang is set at the perfect distance so that any sun rays at that angle will get blocked out from hitting this window. That's what this gray shaded area is right here. And in the winter, that overhang is shallow enough that all these sun rays, which represent where the sun is coming from in December, are getting through and hitting the window. Only this small portion, these few rays up here at this height above the overhang, are getting shaded. So that's the only portion that's going to actually get shaded in the winter. So that's how you get the perfect solar overhang every time. If we come and set, if we look at our 3D view, we can see that shadow is basically perfectly over that window at 1 o'clock on June 21st, which is when we're trying to figure this out. Okay, so real quick, I'm going to cover four ways that you can model this into your project. I'm not going to talk about how I exactly did all these, but you can download this file for free over on hyperfinearchitecture.com. The easiest, quickest way would be to just model a floor. That's what I did in this video. Basically, I used a generic 3-inch floor. I modeled it in plan to be the depth that we needed based on what we found in our section, and then I set the height to where I wanted it to be. If you're looking for a more contemporary look, you can use wall sweeps on an invisible wall. Basically, I set the profile of this wall sweep with this generic rectangle profile family, and then I created basically what I call an invisible wall. It's just a 1-inch thick wall, and then I put it on a workset that's always off. So worksets are a great way to organize your project. Even if you're not working in a large office where multiple people are in the same file, it's good to use worksets. So a lot of times in my projects, I have a workset for things that I need to just be off 99% of the time. And you see, by default, it's not visible. If we turn that on, we can see there's a wall back there. But if I keep that workset off, put the wall sweeps on it, the wall sweeps will remain on even if that wall is on the workset that goes off. You can also use a curtain wall. So instead of just having the windows like they were before, I made this a curtain wall that looks the same, and I've used a different profile to make the mullion act as the shade. So a mullion, just like a wall sweep, just like lots of things in your project, the shape of it is defined by a profile. So if you create a new mullion type, you can create a new profile for it, and use that profile as the mullion shape, and you can see that'll create something similar to just this generic floor. And the fourth thing you can do is maybe just look online if there's a product that already exists. So this one I found on bimobject.com. It's made by Conier, and you know, if there's a product you already know that you're going to use, there's a good chance that maybe that company has made a BIM model for you to use in your project just for, you know, scenarios like this. So this one comes with a ton of parameters you can change, and it's ready to go, and it looks like the finished product that you're going to use. So that's four things. Again, you can download these all on hyperfinearchitecture.com. If you like this video, please like and subscribe, and definitely leave a comment if there's something you want to learn next. Thanks for watching.